comrades, today there's quite a significant event that took place, the appearance of our former president in Pietermaritzburg High Court. Before I came here, I actually watched the proceedings. And I was asking myself a simple question: why am I not there to support the former president? We used to take a pilgrimage to Pietermaritzburg before the 2007 National Conference, what we popularly know as the Bulukwana Conference. Every time when there's this court, we used to go there to give the president of the ANC the necessary support, and would stay there and have rallies after the event, and all of us ANC colors, because we have to defend the president of the ANC who was persecuted. But the NEC took a decision that ANC must not give organizational support to JZ, but rather individual ANC members who wants to give JZ support, they must go there and give him support. And they discouraged display of organizational regalia and paraphernalia that has ANC colors and emblems. This decision, comrades, by the NEC was taken after intensive discussions that took place, very intensive discussions. How are we going to approach the court appearances of the former president? And fortunately, the president, JZ, was part and parcel of the NEC, he attended the NEC. So that was a deliberate and conscious decision taken by the NEC, that individuals who want to support Comrade JZ, they are welcome to go there and give him the necessary support. But the ANC should not be seen to be leading such mobilization and to be leading galvanizing support behind Comrade JZ towards his court hearing. And the reason for that is because of the decisions we took at the National Conference. I don't know how many of you had an opportunity after the conference to read the strategy and tactics. The theme of the strategy and tactics is enhancing organizational integrity and intensifying actions towards the NDR. That is enhancing organizational integrity. That is a need for us to enhance the organizational integrity of the ANC. And we've actually identified four areas of this organizational integrity. So it is leadership integrity. There should be leadership integrity. People must see the leadership of the ANC, which has got integrity, ethical leadership. We can't be seen associated with corruption. So one of the very important issues which was discussed today is the fact that the president is entitled to the presumption of innocence until proven otherwise by a competent court of law. When we speak about integrity, this is the position of the NEC, because it gets diluted when I'm listening in the media. That's the reason I thought it's important for us to articulate this matter here. The position of the NEC, comrades, is very simple. Is that integrity has got nothing to do with guilt or innocence. Integrity has got nothing to do with that. What we should be asking ourselves as the ANC is, what is the impact of the charges on the image of the African National Congress? Whether guilt or innocence. Integrity has got nothing to do with that. And then we said we are going to commit ourselves at enhancing the integrity of the movement. And when we are confronted with such questions, the most important question is, how do we ensure that we enhance the integrity of the African National Congress? I'm sure all of us, we've committed ourselves to the task of ensuring that we are going to fight corruption in all its manifestation, and we are going to ensure that those of us who are deployed to strategic positions of power, they don't use their proximity to resources to rob the poor. That is basically the decisions that we take. And we should be able to, in a practical way, we should be able to express that in a practical way. And one of the practical ways of expressing that is that the ANC should not be seen to be actively involved in mobilizing people when our comrades are confronted with charges of corruption, money laundering, and all of that. So that's the position of the NEC. So with the engagements, comrades, that took place here, there's quite a number of things that came up. And I think one of the issues that we should also reflect on is the fact that this election workshop takes place during a very important month in the political calendar of the ANC. We all know that Comrade Chris and OR died during this month. It's a very important month in our political calendar. And this morning, the Deputy President undertook the 52 steps to the gallows where Solomon Mahlangu was hanged, was executed in 1979. This is, and in the same month, we are going to bury our stalwart, our mother, Comrade Winnie Madikizela Mandela. So we've got this elections workshop during a very critical and important month in the political calendar of the African National Congress. And we have made commitments to a number of issues. I'm not going to highlight the issues which the secretary have highlighted. But I think the issue of the ANC volunteers, we need to highlight it. In 2016, we said we want to mobilize about 30,000 volunteers of the ANC in the province. And we only managed to get about 18,000 volunteers. Did not manage to reach our target of 30,000 volunteers. We managed 30,000, and in 2014, we also had a target of 30,000 volunteers, because we firmly believe for us to run a formidable elections campaign, we need a minimum of 30,000 volunteers in the province. And in 2014, we only managed to get about 24,000 volunteers. 2014, it was 24,000. In 2016, with the local government elections, we had about 18,000 volunteers in the entire province. So I've noted that in some of the resolutions that we took is to ensure that we strengthen the volunteer base of the African National Congress. And something was raised which was very important around the volunteers, is the fact that volunteers are not the unemployed. I think that's the perception that we have about a volunteer. If somebody who's unemployed, who register as an ANC volunteer and who would be there running the elections program, right from the morning up until late in the afternoon. If we volunteerism, it's a form of political activism. To be a volunteer, that's political activism. That's what it is, nothing else. It's political activism. So if you say you are not a volunteer, that means you are not politically active. That's what it actually means. So all of us, when it's time to do door-to-door, if I'm deployed from here to go to Upington to do door-to-door, when I get there, to do and embark in the door-to-door program, I'm the volunteer of the ANC. All of us, disregarding your station in life, when you get engaged in the political program and in our elections campaign, you become a volunteer. That's a form of political activism. So the issues which were raised also is the need for us to strengthen the political outlook of our volunteers, which is very much important. Because if we don't have these education programs which we've embarked over the past few years to ensure that we strengthen the political outlook of our volunteers, we always encounter difficulties. Because the volunteers are the ones who knocks, get inside the household and speak on behalf of the ANC. And if we are not doing much work to invest on the work on the quality of our volunteers, we are always going to encounter difficulties. But I think whilst we are raising those witnesses, we must appreciate the work that the volunteers have done in ensuring that the ANC emerged victorious in all our elections from 1994. Whilst we identify all these witnesses, we must appreciate that work. For us, the volunteers of the ANC are the engine of our campaign. Without the volunteers, there is no ANC campaign. We don't have a campaign altogether. So what we have to do, comrades, whilst we've identified witnesses in the work of the ANC volunteers, we need to strengthen their work. We need to strengthen their understanding of their responsibilities. I saw comrade foot soldier raise something about ideological training and said they must get political training and all of that. It's the same thing. It's the same thing, because political training, it's ideological training. Ideological training is about giving ANC volunteers the ability to understand where the ANC is taking this country to. That's ideological training, where we are taking this country to. So we must invest into that to ensure that we strengthen the volunteers of the ANC. But the best way of strengthening the volunteers of the ANC is not to call them into a workshop. It's to be on the ground with them doing door-to-door. You should be there on the ground and do door-to-door with them. If they do something which is good, you appreciate that and commend that. If there is something, there are certain weaknesses, you identify those weaknesses and collectively with them, you work in addressing those weaknesses. So, comrades, we need to strengthen our volunteer base, and I don't think our target is lesser than 30,000. In the country, we agreed that we need about 200,000 volunteers. The team from National is here. We said we need about 200,000 volunteers. But our target, 2014, was 30,000. We got 24. 2016, it was 30,000. We got only 18,000. So the issue of ensuring that we get ANC volunteers on board is very much important, and we have to look into that. There's an issue, comrades, which the president raised. It was also raised here, the issue of having rapid response teams to ensure, you know, this thing of always going into households, generate a list of grievances. I think it's getting out of fashion. People always tell you that, hey, you are, the ANC is coming here. You guys will just come here to generate grievances. No, the water tap is not working. No, we don't have a sewer network here. We don't have, people are giving you the same problems over and over again. That is the reason why in the NEC we agreed that there should be rapid response teams that should be established, almost in each and every municipality. So those issues that are immediate and can be addressed immediately should be attended to. So that we don't go into households to generate a list of grievances and we disappear, we come back to generate another list of grievances and then we leave. So the rapid response teams, we have to establish them in all municipalities. We have to establish them even with the provincial government. We'll have to find a formula on how best to establish this, so that where there are grievances that we can immediately respond to, we must respond to those grievances. But very important, comrade, with regard to our capacity to mobilize, is getting the alliance partners on board. And I think the Northern Cape, we are different from many other provinces. We've got a very good working relationship with our alliance partners. And it will be easy to get the alliance partners on board to ensure that we implement a very formidable alliance broad elections campaign. And all the years during our elections, we know that the party, COSATU, SANCO, they are always on the forefront in ensuring that we strengthen our elections campaign. But also what is very much important is to ensure that the leaders of the ANC are at the forefront, at the pinnacle, at the cutting edge of this campaign. Particularly with the challenges that we are sitting with now, youth apathy and the fact that most young people just decide to disengage with the processes. We need a very focused ANC youth league in the province. I had a serious engagement with them, complete candor. We need a very focused ANC youth league in the Northern Cape, order to ensure that we come up with campaigns, strategies that will be able to generate the interest of young people. Young people should be responsive to that. So that's one of the challenges that we are sitting with. But what is also important is the fact that we need to strengthen our research capacity. We should be very clinical in this campaign. You can't be punching in the dark if we don't know what we want. We need to strengthen our research capacity. We should know what's our target group, where is it located, and how to reach that target group. So that the little resources that we have are really used in a very wise and very effective way. But also, comrades, what is very much important is the issue of sectoral engagement. I think Comrade Marcel presented the report on sectoral engagement. You know, when we go to elections, we used to have a parallel program, which is called sectoral engagement, where we engage the different sectors of society because we need their support. They have got influence over a number of people. We need their support, young people, religious sectors and business, the disabled. We used to galvanize all these groups behind the political program of the ANC. Then in summary, comrades, there are four most important things that we need to do in order to ensure that we have an overwhelming victory. That's what we want, overwhelming victory with these elections. One of those things that we say is very important, we need a coherent organization. There should be coherence in the work of the structures of the ANC, and there should be coherence in the work of the volunteers of the ANC. Our volunteers need to be properly organized. We need a coherent organization. But at the heart of a coherent organization is its unity. We need a united African National Congress. And if we've got unity within our ranks, the semblance of unity, it's only then that we'll be able to embark on a decent elections campaign. It's only then that we'll be able to embark on a very vibrant and dynamic elections campaign. But if we are divided as the province, we won't be able to do that. So our primary responsibility now is to defend the movement. And the Provincial Executive Committee, we've committed ourselves to tirelessly work for unity in the province. And we are prepared to create enemies for that program. That is the program for which we are prepared to create enemies. So we agreed with the Provincial Executive Committee, if you don't want to work for unity, you disqualify yourself to be part and parcel of this leadership collective. If you're a PEC member and you don't want to work for unity, you don't belong in that PEC. You are disqualifying yourself. So the defining attribute of a PEC member of the ANC in the Northern Cape is working for unity. PEC member, as a starting point, you should be activists for unity. You should fight for unity in each and every corner in the province. The issue of purging of comrades because of their political choices must come to an end. We need to embrace everybody. We must get everybody on board, not for anybody's sake, but for the sake of the African National Congress. Not for anybody's sake. There's not even a single one of us who's more important than the ANC. Not even a single one of us. So, for the sake of the African National Congress, in the Northern, all of us, with no exception, we should be activists for unity. I'm not talking about fake unity. talking about organic and principled unity within our ranks. That's what should guide our work. That's what should guide our work. It can't be that we, all the years we are presiding over the demise of the movement. It can't happen like that. Once we've got people who sacrifice so much. You know, when you get into the house of Comrade Winnie Mandela, you can see sweat and blood written all over that house because of the sacrifices that she has made. So we want everybody to commit themselves to that. But there's much greater burden on the elected leadership to work for unity. We had 4 regional conferences that took place last year. Those comrades who have been elected in those RECs, they should start working to build the African National Congress in the different regions. You see, if you get elected and you become a moody individual who's not prepared to open up the ANC and make the ANC home to everybody, and you want to close up the ANC and make the ANC the house of those who want conference. You can't have an ANC of people who want a conference. You must have an ANC of all of us, all ANC members. You can't have an ANC of conference winners. Hey, this is our ANC conference, and you did not share our perspective. Anyhow, comrades who differed with you were fully entitled to that perspective. When we go to conference, we invite people to express their different views about who they want to support and who they don't want to support. So comrades were fully entitled to their views. We were not even supposed to come to you and ask permission or ask for your views. So those comrades were fully entitled, and our responsibility is to start to embrace each and every member of the African National Congress and make the ANC work in the Northern Cape. But what is important, comrades, in this work for unity that we started soon after our elections as the PEC, is the forthcoming list conference of the ANC. We've got the list conference in September. And very soon, structures of the movement will be, structures of the ANC in the province will be audited. Very intensive process. We should use that process to unite the ANC. You know, one of our biggest challenges, whilst we land with comrades in our governance structures, we even don't know how this comrade came here. How did this comrade come here? Why is he here? It's because of the factional battles within our ranks. Compromise quality because of factional battles. And we end up having a legislature when you look at it, we don't see the ANC we are talking about. So what we need to do is to ensure that when we go to the list conference, it should be inclusive of the different capabilities we have within the ranks of ANC. It should go beyond our factional permutations. It should not be informed by who was a Zandesh or who was a Sylvie, or who was a CR-17, or who was an NDZ-17. Should not be informed by that. It should be informed by the criteria which will be there about the quality of comrades that we need, in order to ensure that we've got a very strong government in the military. So that's one of the issues that we have to look into. And the work of uniting the province has long started. The work of uniting the province have long started. If you've not felt that, if you've not felt that the work of uniting the province have long started, then that means you are not part and parcel of this journey. You are not part and parcel of this journey. We've started the work, and in the process, we are going to create enemies. Because from within our ranks, there are comrades who strive on divisions. When you've got a normal, substantive, United African National Congress, nobody talks about it. But when there's divisions, deep divisions, fragmentations, and polarization in the movement, they emerge as heroes. So we are going to undermine those things. We are going to undermine them. Our primary focus is to unite the African National Congress, have a better ANC, which members of the ANC can be very proud of in the world. What we also need, comrades, is a coherent message. We need a coherent message. We are currently involved in the process of drafting the elections manifesto. Before the team from National leaves, thank you very much, comrades, for your assistance. Can we give them a nice round of applause? Thank you very much for your assistance, comrades. We need a coherent message, comrades. We can't go into elections with conflicting messages. I think what was said here by the comrades was very important by one commissioner. I think it's on communication. That we need many, many voices, one message. That's what we need. All ANC members, wherever you are, you need to be a voice for the African National Congress. Not only a voice in terms of your lips and tongue, but in terms of how you utilize your access to social media. How you utilize your access to social media at this critical moment, you would be expecting all ANC members with access to social media, Twitter, Facebook, and all of them, to use them as instrument to mobilize people behind the banner of the African National Congress. That's what a Twitter should be, that's what Facebook should be now. That I'm going to utilize my access to this social media platform in order to ensure that I advance the elections campaign of the ANC. So that's the call that we have to take out today. That we need a coherent message. We need many voices in many social media platforms, but one coherent message that we should take through. And we've got all the reasons to celebrate the 24 years of freedom. We've got all the reasons to do that. The kind of massive improvements that we brought to the lives of the people in this country, and the kind of programs that we embarked on in order to ensure that we fight poverty and destitution in the country. We've made major strides, but we just need to start communicating that. And that's not only the sole responsibility of the communications team, but it's the responsibility of each and every member, and each and every member of the ANC. The other issue, comrades, which is very much important, I've mentioned four critical issues that are very much important for this campaign. It's coherent organization, coherent message, and the issue of resources. There's never been a time in the life of the ANC where we had adequate resources for elections. It has never happened. Comrade Tipu was once a treasurer in the province. This is the most difficult time for the ANC treasurers. You know, if somebody can say, Comrade Saul, we want to elect you to be the provincial treasurer of the ANC, I'll commit suicide, I must be honest. When he comes back to me the next day, I'm dead. Because that's the most difficult task. Most difficult task. We've made a preliminary budget for these elections. They will cost us millions. Just to do the primary things, feeding of volunteers, elections paraphernalia, and all of it, cost us millions. So there will never be adequate resources. But if we work smart, we can be able to ensure that each and every cent that gets deposited into an ANC account is used wisely and effectively. Because the layer of people who are funding ANC programs is becoming thinner and thinner and thinner every day. So what we have to do is to ensure that those little resources that we have, we use them wisely. Comrade Tipu will tell you that there's one structure you can't rely on when you go to elections, it's national. They are sitting with their own deep problems that side. And we'll have to do our own fundraising to ensure that we get the necessary resources. Regions are fundraising. There's massive fundraising campaigns which are taking place in regions. I see branches have also developed capacity to fundraise. But what is fundraised What is fundraising and is due to the ANC must come to the ANC. It must come to the ANC. It can't be that comrades, when we meet comrades and say, please, can you assist the ANC for fundraising? And they will tell us, no, I gave the ANC 500,000 rand. And when you speak to the comrade, he would even give you the name of the person who gave the money. No, I gave this money to this person. At least, comrades, if you think you must fundraise and fundraise for the ANC, split it in half, 50-50. It will take us very far. 50-50 arrangement can take us very far. 50-50 arrangement can take us very far. Yes, I'm telling you, just 50-50 arrangement can take us very far. So when we fundraise, let's fundraise for the ANC. Let's not fundraise for our own pockets. Money that is due to the African National Congress must go come to the ANC. And I'm happy I see there's lots of senior managers. Comrades, the ANC account is fully functional. There's no problem with that account. We've got even two accounts, isn't it? All of them, they work perfectly. No problems with that account. It can't be that we meet a business person and said, no, I was asked to load this money and deliver it in cash because there's problems with the ANC account. No, we were told the ANC account does not work. No, I'm certain half of you who are seated here, what you know is that our account does not work. But the ANC account is fully functional. It works perfectly. Here's the treasure. So what is due to the ANC? I can still remember the Comrade John used to make a call for 10%. Can the comrades remember who was serving in the last PC? So the comrades who are fundraising for the ANC, just give us 10% of what you fundraise, and then we can keep the 90%. So I'm increasing it, I'm asking for 50%. Because I know that we are losing lots of money through an not properly coordinated fundraising campaign, but we need lots of resources. If we say we need 30,000 volunteers, that means we must feed 30,000 volunteers. Spoo raised a very important point today about the outlook of our volunteers, us getting them. We tried with the 2016 elections to get them overalls, which were, the Butuli volunteers, and to enable people to identify ANC volunteers. I think that program fell flat. We must start to resuscitate it. And I think Gauteng, they've got a beautiful program. They call, what's their volunteers? Gauteng? Moses Mabhida volunteers. Moses Skotana volunteers, yes. They've got the Skotana volunteers. They've got best coordinated campaign for the volunteers. But comrades, the last thing that we need men and women power. We need everybody's shoulder behind them in order to ensure that we are going to run a very successful campaign. So thanks for your presence. This is starting of a very long journey to ensure that we are going to ensure that we get the overwhelming majority victory. It's 13 months from now, isn't it? To April next year, is it 13 months from now? April next year. 12 months. Yes, it's 12 months from now. Yeah, April or May next year, 12 months from now, 12, 13 months from now. Which means we are not far away from the elections coming.